And hello, my cats. And just talking about it just makes me want to cry.
These are like the low moments, right? This is the hardest part. And then you just go up from here.
I cannot speak anymore. The emotion is coming in.
So what are we talking about today? I read your little blurb about not being able to do stuff that you should do.
My dad recently pointed out that I have no purpose in life. And it's kind of like this. And it's probably one of the reasons that I am unable to do stuff, because I don't have any kind of goal afterwards to chase. And then everything is just like, do what I enjoy, which is like playing games. But like, I'm not good enough to be like a pro player in like Counter-Strike or anything like this. So
this is good timing, man, because I'm right now editing a video, like a full guide I made on purpose. And I'm thinking about like why we struggle to think about what we're good at and what maybe the world could use from us and all that. So I could just start with like the outline that I've made, and that is, what would you say that your current like life constraints are? Like, what are you struggling with?
So probably my place of living. I'm living in a village, and hello, my cat. And it's I'm living 30 minutes away from the closest kind of city with a car. But even though I'm 20, I have my license, but I don't have my car, my own car. And if my parents don't have any car, like they are not home, I cannot use it. And also, I am studying in completely different city compared to my closest city. I'm studying around 2 hours away from my home. And I have most of my friends are there, but I'm not living there. On these 5 days and I'm not in school, I'm basically just sitting on my PC and just playing games, doing absolutely nothing, because I just don't feel going anywhere, because I don't have many friends. I don't have any friends, to be honest, in the closest city. But going to the other city is just a pain. For example, I have a friend that goes to gym there. I would love to go to gym, but I do not want to go solo. And knowing that I don't have the same gym and in my city compared to the one that he's going, and buying two different memberships at the same time is just pointless for me. And going like two times a week is also pointless for me. At least I feel like it's pointless. Maybe I'm wrong. Right now, I'm a freelancer. I'm just living in my parents' house and I'm just studying. I have studying economics of finances and business. Mm-hmm. And it's a 3-year course, and it's kind of buying me time to decide what the hell am I wanting to do with life.
What are you doing for freelance work?
Well, freelance. What I meant with freelance is like I'm basically sitting in my home just doing nothing. That's the problem. And I try to start editing and then it falls apart. It just simply falls apart because I don't know where to get the things, like any kind of materials. You can call me a special kid if you can, because since young, I had no problems with learning. I had no problems with anything. Turns out I had ADHD, and later on in completely even evolved into autism, which is an Asperger syndrome. And I am like, you can see it by me. By what I'm doing stuff. When I, for example, when I play and I'm like really focused, I can play 6 hours and then look out the window. Oh, it's already dark. Yeah, if I find something that I actually enjoy, I can do it with no stopping. But when stuff gets hard, even in games, it's hard to get over that bump.
What was your reaction to when your dad said that you have no purpose?
Not much. I knew it. And so it wasn't like it wasn't even a shock. So it's kind of sad to say, but it's like, well, I know that I don't have any. I'm trying to find it for like 2 years. Since I'm 18, I realized that, and I'm trying to find something. But it never like came along. Like nothing works. No clock tries to fit in.
So when you finish school, do you have a plan, so to speak?
No, that's the problem. I have no plans. Well, I thought about going to kitchen, like do some kitchen work. I really like cooking. I am enjoying it. So if I'm wanting to move there, so I'm close to friends also.
Well, I think it's important to recognize if you want to have a massive career, because I think we all get pressured into saying that you need to have a really good job and XYZ has to happen. But if you really enjoy cooking, then why couldn't you just do that as your job?
Well, I'm want to retire pretty quickly. It's just I am not capable of working 8 hours a day for the rest of my for like 40 years. I'm not capable of that. I am a person that, like, as I said earlier, I have an Asperger syndrome, and it's like if I'm gonna get burned out pretty quickly just from working every day 8 hours or even longer. I'm just it's not for me. So what I want to do is just find good enough job where I can live like from 30 or 40 years old onwards. I just want to retire and just not do anything more. That's why maybe not I do not want to get good career just for the sake of it. Just more likely I just want to earn as much money to the point where I can just retire. And like a small goal kind of mine is to buy a Koenigsegg. At one point of my life, I want to have a Koenigsegg. It's a hypercar,
Oh yeah, I know that car.
and it's like $2 million at least. And I really love it. I really like the brand. I really like the prestige of it. And just want to have it at some point of my life. Some people say they want a Ferrari at some point. I just want Koenigsegg. As I say, like more of the brand, finding a way to make money, even if I'm like, for example, I retire practically, but I have a, for example, stocks job or something like this that I do like 2 or 3 hours a day of like checking what's going on in the market, for example, and that way I make more money after I retire would be cool. But yeah, I have a friend that already does that, and he tries to teach me that, but he sent me like 2 months ago stuff to learn. I never opened the email.
I will never tell people just be realistic, because there are people out there that can afford a Koenigsegg, and they can, like Andrew Tate can buy a $3 million Bugatti. Like, it's possible to do that. But at the same time, it's important to understand the method of getting to that. Because if you're going to buy a car that expensive, then you have to make millions of dollars. And like, if you don't even open the email that your friend sent you, then like, you kind of have to bridge this gap of like, I want this goal. And I know that I have to make a lot of money, but then in the middle of that, you actually have to like do something to facilitate you getting to that goal. Like, I feel like to get to that level, you have to start like a business of sorts. Have you thought about that?
Yeah, the problem is what kind of business? I have no idea which kind of business would I open. And by myself, I know it's just I'm incapable of doing something I don't like. Like if I hate something, I'm gonna get burned out in like 5 minutes.
Well, and so what do you like to do?
Right now, I just like to game. That's probably the only thing I mostly do.
But you said that you only have two classes, right?
Yeah, 2 school days.
So you have a lot of free time?
Yeah, a bunch of it.
And so you spend most of that gaming.
Yeah.
But you know that you could spend some of that time learning some sort of
Yeah.
online business, right? And what has stopped you from doing that? Because it just seems too like elusive or too difficult.
It feels like, well, even if I start, and what about that? Well, then I pick up things quickly. But going to that next level of like trying to compete for championships or something like this was like elusive, impossible.
Why do you think it's impossible to follow that path of like a professional setting?
Mean, I'm playing games since I'm 16. Never got any far, so probably not gonna happen.
But is that,
Plus,
but are you just playing though, or are you practicing intentionally?
well, whenever I'm playing, I'm trying to rank up, for example. I'm always trying to think where what I'm doing wrong. The problem is when you're playing solo queue, I am pretty explosive character. So I'm playing in a at the end of the day, I end up screaming out of on top of my lungs because people are stupid in these games in my Elo. And then people say that you're gonna get the same thing in higher Elos, and I'm like, bruh, what am I supposed to do?
Everything always comes back to mentality. And if you treat everything like it's going to be impossible, then it will be impossible for you. And I mean, I can't know what it's like to have, you know, as you say, autism or ADHD. But I do know that if you approach everything like you're going to fail, then that's probably what's going to happen, right?
Yeah, I mean, the funny part is I don't do it like this. I try to go like it's going to happen and everything. But then just talking about it just make me want to cry. It's funny.
Yeah, I mean, it is difficult to have nowhere to go. I mean, it's really strange timing how I'm writing this video right now about purpose. And
yeah, that is funny.
Like, I know what it's like to be, you know, when I was younger, 17, 18, and I had no idea what to do. I genuinely did not even know what I was going to study. And I was like, what on earth can I do, you know? But you just kind of have to go towards things that you might not succeed at them. Like, I didn't intend to immediately succeed with YouTube, and you just try, you know, because at least maybe you get the experience of going out there. And like, I used to try to sell stuff, sell art on Etsy.com, and that didn't go anywhere. Like, I failed for like 6 months straight. But, you know, you just go through the motions, and I mean, at least it is still motion, right? You're still trying something. And like, yeah, you said, you're 20. You're still so young. You don't have to figure it out right now.
Yeah. And just the idea of like getting to the point of like, I don't know, I finish school and I end up with a generic job. And instead of like after 20 years, I say, well, I enjoyed life. Now I can die or just enjoy the rest of it. Instead, I'm gonna need to work 6 years just to get a retirement fees from my country that don't even help me to stay every day.
I promise, dude, the solution to that is, I know it's difficult, but starting some sort of online endeavor. Like, that's the entire reason I do YouTube, because I know that my job, like, I would be in the same boat as you. If I didn't have YouTube, if I didn't have anything going for myself, then I would be working an average job, making average money, and I would be so depressed, you know? You have to try something. And, like, I wouldn't say, like, a lot of people get in this trap of, like, oh, just do drop shipping, do this. It's like, put your toes everywhere. That's probably not going to work. You have to pick one thing. But if you want to have the supercar, then you have to find something.
The same thing Bruce Lee said, like, I'm not scared of a person that train one kick. I mean, 100,000 of kicks one time. I'm scared of a person that practice one kick 100,000 times.
Yeah.
Like, I just probably need to start throwing stuff at the wall and see what sticks.
Yep.
The problem is it is kind of a terrifying, like, you know, when you have a bunch of options, you're just terrified of picking one if you have too many options, because you are scared that you choose the wrong one.
Well, the solution to that is to narrow down the scope based on what you think that you're naturally good at, which might be hard to know, but for me, it's...
I have no idea.
Yeah, right. But like, for me, it's, I'm good at writing, communicating, and talking with people. I'm not good at math or physics or engineering or anything technical. So I want to pick things that I know will best suit me. And I just talked with someone about this, where I stopped doing a certain business model because I knew that it was not suited to my skill set, right? You have to pick things that are aligned with you at your core. And I mean, you know that better than I do, obviously, but, you know, don't pick something just because you think that people say that it's a good business model or it'll make you a lot of money, when you know that that's actually not what you're good at.
I am pretty good at talking, I think. That's the thing that I'm good at.
Mm-hmm.
It's just talk about what, like, that's the thing.
Anything.
Just thinking about starting a podcast. I mean, you can start a podcast, but how the hell do I get it off the ground? I have no idea about that.
I wouldn't honestly start a podcast. I honestly think that with YouTube specifically, what people just want is someone in their room talking about what comes to mind. And I know for a fact that there's other people, many other people in the world that have the same ADHD, autism, same struggles as you, and they would probably benefit from hearing someone's experience. And you have so much free time, right? You could do that. You could make videos in your room and talk about this kind of thing, and people would like it.
Yeah, that is true.
I do think that there, you've got potential. I can see it. And I mean, you've got the ambition for sure. I mean, I want a Koenigsegg too, right? But we just have to narrow down our scope a bit and think about like what you're good at and then just do it. Because you've got the time, you've got the free time. And I know that with enough time, it might not happen immediately. You will figure it out. It's these are like the low moments, right? This is the hardest part. And then you just go up from here.
Do you have any like idea of how to narrow the scope? Of like what I'm good at? Like how to start with it? Because I have no idea.
Well, I'll tell you what. I think that I'll probably be able to finish, edit, and upload this purpose video either today or tomorrow. And so when it comes out, I want you to watch it. And it's going to lay out step by step how I found my purpose, what I'm good at.
Yeah.
And then from there, think about what you're good at, what you think that the world would benefit from, you know, maybe your story and experiences, and what you think is the most realistic way to get paid doing that. And just combine those things. And I think that you'll figure it out.
I cannot speak anymore. It's just the emotion is coming in.
Yeah, I get it, man. Like, it's hard. It's hard for sure.
Yeah, but like bottling up 20 years, it will come out somewhere.
Right. Well, Matthew, I do appreciate you coming on. I know that this is a difficult conversation, recognizing where you're going in life. It's hard, but just promise me that you're going to spend some time looking into it. You know,
I'm gonna call you in sometime.
Yeah,
I'm gonna do it again.
Yeah, absolutely. I would love you to come back and tell me how it's going. Yeah, I'm sure people will love to see your cat too.
Yeah, yeah. Hope so. Yeah, she's sleeping in my bed right now. So yeah, yeah. Thank you too. I mean, it was really helpful to talk with you.
Absolutely, man.